Believe it or not, I'm standing on the ocean floor of the Minas Basin, home to the highest tides in the world here on the Bay of Fundy in Nova Scotia. What we're looking at in the distance here is known as Cape Blomidon, a hill range or a mountain range known as the North Mountain Range that runs all the way down to Digby from the Minas Basin. But today we're not going to focus on the tides. Today we're going to focus on pirates, waterfalls, and sea caves.
Join me as I traverse rivers, scale cliffs, and discover hidden waterfalls as I explore the natural wonder that is the Bay of Fundy. I'm your host, Ryan Berry. This is Great Earth Expeditions, the Travel Series.
I've always been fascinated by the Bay of Fundy and its 50-foot tides, the captivating colors of the red sandstone, the rolling green hills, and the expanse of farmlands. But many people have never seen the numerous waterfalls that tumble down the coastal side of the North Mountain Range. Rising above the Annapolis Valley to just over 750 feet, what the North Mountain Range lacks in height, it makes up for in great character. Giant cracks beneath the water's surface once violently spewed up lava from the ocean floor, which cooled from the powerful incoming tides to create imposing cliffs and massive sea stacks.
I'm now here at Baxter's Harbor with Baxter's Harbor Falls in the background. This particular area was once a fishing port. There used to be an old wharf that used to stretch out into the bay here. It was quite a lively community at one time, and now there's only a few people who live here. And at one time, this was the stomping grounds for pirates. It's amazing to think that the pirates would come in here in high tide. At low tide, this completely drains out, leaving nothing but rock.
I didn't think heading into a sea cave alone was going to be a good idea, so I waited for the tides to recede and I gathered up a team of guys to help me explore the pirate caves.
Jesse, what's a pirate's favorite letter?
R.
No, it'd be the sea.
Yeah. Why do pirates like chunky soup so much?
Why's that?
Because she's hearty.
Falls is an interesting waterfall. It's off the coast of the Bay of Fundy, not visible from the Bay of Fundy, perfect spot for pirates. Back in the day when pirateering was a major thing around the Bay of Fundy, the pirates would take their gold up this waterway to this 40-foot waterfall. It probably only stands about 20 feet now. I'm probably sitting on about 20 feet of ice.
Local legend has it that there used to be an old pit up in these mountains somewhere where the pirates would come up through this inlet and bury their treasures.
Q
Somewhere between Black Hole Falls and the Bay of Fundy, gold coins and mysterious markings had been found and collected. Some 200 years ago, the falls provided Norwegian pirates with not only a safe and protected base camp, but with a plentiful supply of fresh water. The hole near the falls that was once used as a treasure bank collapsed sometimes in the 1970s, washing away any evidence of pirates and the secrets that they hold to this area. These picturesque falls are now known as Porcupine Falls after one of my photos was published in a book called Lost in Nova Scotia back in 2006. They were named this as a tribute to a porcupine I used to see here who lived at the bottom of the falls in his den. He has since passed away, but his legacy still lives on.
Is what's known as old man's beard. This stuff grows on a lot of the trees here in Nova Scotia, especially spruce trees, coniferous trees, and it's characteristics of two things. One, a very clean air, and two, a very moist air. And here in Nova Scotia during the winter time, we get our fair share of precipitation.
And last but not least, Kobe Irving Falls.
Well-known hideout for pirates. A perfect place for them. As you can see, there's huge cliffs surrounding the waterfall. We're only a 10-minute walk to the Bay of Fundy. They would arrive in ship, they would unload all their gold, treasure, and rum. They would take it up this riverbed and bring it here. Stash their gold here in the cliffs, as you can see by one of the small caves over here.
All of these pirate hideouts were strategically chosen. It's no coincidence that they all contained a source of water, impenetrable rock walls that acted as a natural castle, and were close to the Bay of Fundy itself where they could dock their ships. A combination of primitive skills and violent ways made pirates the most feared and notorious villains of the sea. Join us next time as we explore more of Nova Scotia and abroad, and bring you along for the adventure. Safe travels. This is Great Earth Expeditions, the Travel Series.